I personally don't have experience with the father being the better fit.
Oh, with the father being a better kid?
Yeah, with the kids and everything.
So, do you have children?
I do. I have a daughter. I am the sole provider for her. My her father doesn't do anything.
What do you think that is?
I think he wasn't ready for her, and I end up finding out that he actually had like a whole different life. So,
What do you mean when you say a whole different life? Like,
but he had other children and everything. So when I found that out, I was just like very shocked.
he had
And
another kid or other children?
other children.
So let me ask you, how long was you with him?
A
Doing
year.
a year?
Yes.
So you got pregnant as soon as you met him then? Because it takes like 9.5, 10 months to carry the baby. So he wasn't there for the birth of your daughter?
He wasn't there. He didn't he is it's like he didn't want to be involved until she got here. And it was like good for like 2 months. It was great. He was around. He was seeing her. But when he started to not keep his word about helping out and being there financially, because at the time, like, and I was on maternity leave, I actually told my doctor, well, I have to, make money for my daughter, so I can't be on maternity leave for like 6 weeks. I could be on there for two, that's it. And I went straight back to work. But he wasn't there. He wasn't helping on anything. So that made me disconnect from him and just say I'm done.
Where is he now?
I
How
don't
long ago was that?
know. This was 4 years ago.
So when is the last time he saw his daughter?
Last time he saw his daughter was 2021. And
So,
that's by choice. He doesn't call. Like I call him, I say, hey, you want to talk to her? Every time a birthday comes, every time Christmas, but I stopped doing that personally a year ago because I realized it was falling on deaf ears. If he wanted to be there and make an effort, he would.
have you asked him why doesn't he come and see his daughter regularly, and why isn't he providing?
He always said he's busy. The last time I asked him, he said he was busy. And me knowing like people make time for what they want, and me just also understanding that you can never be too busy for your child. That's my opinion. And
Okay,
I
so
mean, I just grew up and just figured it out. He just doesn't want to be around or involved. His
well,
actions is speaking louder than his words. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
he shouldn't have that option. He has a responsibility there. Why don't you
Agree.
call him up and tell him you need to see your you need to come and visit your daughter. You need to see your daughter. You need to spend some time with your daughter.
He says that the same thing. Like my last effort, I honestly came to him and said, "Hey, she has a birthday coming up in like 2 weeks. It would be nice if you would be involved with her. Like I'm not asking for money or anything like that. I'm actually be present. That's more valuable than money to me." And he just the only thing he said after me saying that, the only thing he said was, "Take me off child support then." And I was like, is that the only thing you care about? And there was just no difference. There was no difference. And it's not like and I know every time somebody hear that a woman put a man on child support, they thinking, oh, you getting $500 checks, this and that every month. But no, he barely pays it. Anybody that knows the system, they know how to cheat it. If you pay some amount on it, you won't go to jail. They won't come looking for you, whatever. Unless the mother pushed the issue. He only has to pay $100 a month. That's it. It's not like he's a bum. It's not like he doesn't work, doesn't have businesses. He has all that. He's driving a new BMW. He's driving a 22 BMW right now. When I came to him trying to say, hey, come see your daughter, talk to her, say happy birthday to her, give her a present, you know. He was wearing Ferragamo shoes, a Gucci shirt, all that stuff. And then saying, again, he's busy. And I'm just like, but you won't put no effort into your daughter. Like, forget me. I'm not asking you to do anything with me. I'm asking you to be present with her, and you don't. So, and then also, from what my experience with my parents on why women leave with the children and everything, my mom left with me and my sisters because my dad was just out there in the streets. And my mom, you know, she's a smart lady. My dad too. They both graduated college. They're smart. And it's just like they had a plan, and then my dad just decided to go do what he wanted to do. And since that, like, he was in and out of my life, and I told him when I was 16, hey, I'm not the in and out type of person. Either you're gonna stay or you're not. He chose not to. And that's it. That, like, I mean, I feel like it's a good thing a woman has strength enough to leave a bad situation or something that's not working out. Now,
So,
if the parents can come together if they could come together to take care of the kids, just solely the kids, 50-50 or however it is, co-parenting, then that's great. Because at the end of the day, it's all about the kids.
right. So, you said you was with this guy for a year.
I was with him for a year, and then getting pregnant within that year, and then after that, it honestly just went downhill.
Right, so when you from the point that you was with this guy, before you spread your quiver to him, how long did you know him?
I know him.
Still there? Dune. She blocked out. Like, Queen, you guys can still hear me?
Yeah, we hear you. Can't hear her.
Yeah, she just went mute.
You can hear us, you can go ahead and leave the room.
No,
Come.
I'm sure she would say something if she could, she's probably having a mic issue or something. So I'm trying to probe and find out what really happened. Because what I'm hearing here is Danae really didn't have a father in her life throughout her entire growing up. She seems to think her father was wrong. She said, he was running out in the streets. I would like to get more detail on that. There could have been something at home that was actually causing him to run out. I'm not want to be at home. A lot of men go through that. I'm not saying that's the case, but I'd like to hear more on that and know how much she actually knew about that particular situation. Dune, we can't hear you. Can you go out and come back in? Should I leave in a room and coming back in? Because we can't hear you anymore. But definitely appreciate you coming on. Kadal, what happened to that? She never came through?
That Eve probably in the
club somewhere, huh? Yeah, man. She didn't stay while they fell off, right?
No, so to get to all of that, couldn't get. Donay, leave the room and come back in because we can't hear you.
She's unmuted. I didn't have a connection issue. She
went mute, D.
My sound keep going in and out. I turned my phone off and turned it back on.
Something just happened to hers also. So we're pausing for a second here.
D, you got her contact info? You give her a call maybe?
Yeah, I just text her and told her to come back on if she could.
Okay, she just blinked out and blinked back in. Vince Jordan, what do you have? Vincel Jordan. Okay, no word from him either. All right, I was trying to get to the jits of it. I wanted to listen to what she was saying. Then I was just going to give her some probing questions to try and find out what's really going on here. I definitely like to hear that guy's side of the story. Maybe she could call him up. I wonder if she could call him up, see if we could get him on here. Say, hey man, why don't you want to take care of your... She's saying you want to take care of your daughter. What's going on here? She go.
Okay.
Yes.
Perfect.
Now I think you got a YouTube up.
Okay.
You still there? You just went out again. Mm-hmm. All right. So, do you still talk to this guy?
I do not talk to him. Haven't talked to him, spoke to him in a year.
He needs to be in his daughter's life. That has a very adverse effect when the father's not in the kid's life. He really needs, we only hear your side of the story, but he really needs to mature and be a part of his daughter's life, especially since you're claiming that you want him to be a part of her life. He needs to get involved.
I agree. For 2 solid years, I tried. Like, I'm not the type to where I'm going to be loud and belligerent. I'm not going to, I never cussed him out. I never threatened him. I never did none of the stereotype baby mom situations. All I ever asked him was to be present because I know how valuable for a father to be in a child's life. My dad was in my life for a period of time, but my grandfather was the one that really showed me what a man is supposed to do, what it is. My grandfather was my dad growing up. And then even now, my stepdad is really, he took over being my daughter's father. Like, when I tell you...
Where's your biological father?
He passed away. unfortunately, he passed away 2 years ago. I just know the strength behind a father having both parents being present. I know how powerful that is. I feel like that's all I really wanted for my daughter, and I just feel bad that I just picked the bad part.
That's what I wanted to come to. Like, what part of responsibility are you willing to assume for selecting a bad mate? Did you not see some of these things in this guy at the beginning of the relationship?
I did, but honestly.
You said you did or you didn't?
I did. Pregnancy never came to mind. Not saying I didn't know the consequences of having unprotected sex, but I was taking a pill. I thought I was fine. I honestly thought it would never, like, you know how you think it never will happen to you?
Right.
That's what I thought. I just wasn't thinking. And it just really just happened.
I think you should call that guy and tell him he needs to see his daughter. I think you to call him. Did his he have phone, his father in his life?
His phone might not even work.
Did he have his father in his life?
Until he was like, I think he said until he was like 16 or 17.
Okay.
And then his father, I don't know, either left or he passed away, but he just like, you know, he's Nigerian. And he came to the States when he was 12.
Okay.
And yeah, you know how people have different cultures and different beliefs and everything. So I just.
Yeah, I've heard, you know. So you was born in America?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you're the second female that I talked to that got with someone from there. And it was kind of nightmarish. The other guy was kind of similar to what you're explaining right here. And he was from over there.
And you know how some people say, like, you know, Africans take care of their kids, they're there for their kids and everything. It's, you know, no. I mean, I can't speak for all, but definitely for one I have laid down with, he doesn't do nothing for my daughter. And I have came to terms with myself and just said, like, if he decides he doesn't want to do this, it's his loss. It's his loss. And I was debating for years, what should I, if my daughter ever asks about her father, what should I say?
I think that's my opinion is that you should contact him and tell him to grow up and be a part of his daughter's life, because he's scarring his daughter, that his daughter needs him. Don't have nothing to do with you, but he needs to be a part of her life. He helped create the life. He needs to be a part of it while she's young. He doesn't need any kind of relationship with you if you don't want to be with him. But he needs to assume some responsibility with his daughter.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, kind of really gave me a little courage to call him up maybe tomorrow and see. I don't know if he changed his number or what. I don't know if the number I have still works. So.
Yeah. He needs to be in his daughter's life. He had his father until he was 17. Pretty much he was a man. Mm-hmm. So you would think that he wouldn't behave like that. But then again, the customs are totally different. We don't know what kind of tribe or whatever he may have actually come from.
Right.
But that's pretty typical that they will have more than one family. You see how you said you felt like he had another family?
Mm-hmm.
It's typical A lot of them are Muslims, so you know, a lot of them, you know, they kind of like, it's a natural thing for them.
So, sister, I have a question for you. What actually attracted you to him initially when y'all met?
Come again?
What actually had attracted you to him when y'all met?
We met at a coffee shop. So it was, I worked there and he was just a regular customer. And it was a smile. And just to give y'all more insight, he's like, I'm 26 and he's like almost 50. He doesn't look his age.
No. It doesn't matter. I mean,
he swindled.
You don't really have to justify that because men of status usually want younger women anyways. They usually want women that's fertile and can reproduce. So the younger, the better. So we understand that over here probably better than anyone. So you don't have to justify that. But what I'm not liking, if you're telling the truth, is how he's not assuming responsibility of his daughter. That's what's disturbing me.
It disturbs me too. I would never in a million years would I have thought this would happen. Like, it's talking about it now, I'm still just bothered and just baffled. Like, whoa.
I wish you could get that guy on the call. So the child support, you said that he could get away with it. Not really. So what he would be paying on is the arrears. You see what I'm saying? You have child support, and then you have what is known as the arrears, what he already missed already. But I guess what you're saying is he's compliant, but still, you have like a if his child support is $500 a month, he's only paying $100, then the arrears is accumulating, and then they put interest onto that. Well, so even how old is your daughter right now? Four.
She's four.
Yeah. So. Even in 14 years, when she's 18, he would still be paying that unless he just paid off all of the arrears. Because that's accumulating, especially if he's only paying $100 a month. But some states have different, you know, rules against that. You see, you say only if the mom enforce it. But does he pay it to you or does he pay it through the state?
Through the state.
Okay. So now when that gets to a certain amount, the authorized representative, you know what the maximum amount of child support debt is before they try and lock you up? When it reaches, because if he's only paying $100 on $500 a month,
that's how much the child support order is, just $100.
So he doesn't have a job?
I was just basically giving an example how, because what I have ran into, a lot of women have told me, oh, my baby father pays $300 a month, $500. Sometimes I heard somebody say $800 one time, and I said, Lord Jesus, what do he do? Oh, my goodness, $800 a month? I wish I could get that. Okay, if he's not present, I wish I could get that, but he only pays $100.
Something's wrong. Hold on, sis, time out. Does he work?
Mm-hmm. He owns businesses. He owns... Okay. I don't know if y'all familiar with Ohio. It's called Eastland Mall. He owned that.
All right, very good, very good, very good. Okay, so he owned businesses. When you did the mediation for child support, did he bring in those pay stubs and what?
No, when we did the mediation for child support, that's when my daughter was like probably like 8 months old.
Okay, so did he have those businesses then?
From what I know, he just had the car lot business and he owned two properties.
Okay, and did he bring in any pay stubs and all?
He did. And from how they calculated, they said that.
Were you working then?
I was a waitress.
How much was you earning then? Minimum wage?
I was earning below minimum wage.
All right. So, there's no way he should have been just paying $100. And What about what was his monthly gross income? Do you know?
I do not know at the time. Honestly, I was just so young and just like.
Okay, you know what you need to do? You need to give him a call and say, listen, you need to take care of your daughter. You need to start giving me at least $500 a month. If he owns all these businesses, or tell him I'm going to do a modification on the child support. That's what you need to tell him. He's walking around in these name brand designer things, and he doesn't want to take care of his daughter. He doesn't want to see her. I don't even believe in the system, but this is why it needs to exist for certain guys, man. Mm-hmm. Guys like this, it needs to exist. If you're telling the truth, because this guy is getting away with, you know, yeah, you know, some of them just got to get it. So what you need to do, you give him a call and say, I'm giving you the opportunity. And if he says no, go down to the court and tell him you want to do a modification. Then you get him served. Tell the lady to show you how to draw up a summons. Do you know where he live at?
I do not.
You need to find out where he lives at.
What I found out all is like, I did one of those Google, you know, reports.
Listen,
and stuff. Everything is in somebody else's name of his.
Okay, yeah, of course. That's how they move. That's how those kind of people move. It's probably an Unfufu's name. But you need to find out where he lives at. You got to find out where he lived. Well, mm-hmm. So if you don't know where he lived, the way that the court system works is that you will use the last known address and send it there. Tell him you don't know his address. I put the last name address. To the best of my ability, this is where he's living. Well, now, if he's paying support, if he's making it out to the court, they got to have some sort of information on him. Well, either it's coming from a bank account, or he's writing a check or something. There's got to be a way to trace that. You see what I'm saying? To get him served. Because you're going to have to get him served, right? And then if you can't find his address, what the court is going to tell you is to send it to the last known address. Well, and after that, if he doesn't show up, then you get a default judgment against him. So, which they will rule for a higher, but you need to prove that he's making more. So this is why he's only paying 100. Everything's in someone else's name. Mm-hmm. See? Everything's in someone else's name.
And then also, I blame myself a little bit because I'm not pushing the envelope on getting more money because I came up with
I don't believe in it either. But this is one of the ways you strong on him to make him be in his daughter's life. I don't really believe in the child support system. But for him, he needs to feel some sort of wrath. I don't believe
he's been getting by for like 4 years now.
Right.
Like right now he owes, I checked this yesterday, so it's very accurate. Right now he owes $549.
Oh, that ain't nothing.
That's him missing 4 months of not paying.
What?
Yesterday he paid $140 out of that $400.
Find out where that payment's coming from. Do a modification.
Mm-hmm.
If you know this stuff is in someone else's name, you need to go to the court with that information. Can you prove that that's in someone else's name?
Mm-hmm.
This is not legal advice.
What about the bank account? Is that in someone else's name or his?
I do not know.
You need to find that out. So you need to find out where he banks at, and if any of that is pointing to him, because it doesn't really matter. The fiat is in the bank. It's up for grabs. If it's going into his account, this is what I'm telling you. If he got more money going into his account that he can account for, then he can be audited. Because he needs to be able to explain where that money's coming from.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It's just like one of them, those booty scratches. That's how they move. Seriously.
Yeah. Now I know.
They move like that.
And there's actually another girl that I talk to, because I'm a talk to. I have random conversations with random people sometimes. She was explaining to me that she's the same way, in the same boat. Like, she thought, like, it, everything was all nice and dandy until, like, the actual baby came, and that's when he just disappeared. And she said that he told her, I'm going to be there. All Africans are there in their kids' lives and all that stuff. And he ran off, went back to his country. I was like, oof. I don't know where mine's at, but dang. My bad.
That's wild, but huh?
Very wild. Very.
Is he Ethiopian? Wild. Is he Ethiopian?
No, Nigerian. She said Nigerian.
Nigerian, yeah. They play a lot of games.
I just look at them as individuals. I think this is an individual thing. But she needs to track him down. Someone that has to be able to point to him for him to get access to it.
Exactly. And then one time they said that $200 was on hold. And it's because this was like during tax season. And they explained it to me. They said because something, I can't remember. This was like 2 years ago. And I was like, but that money needs to be to me, like my baby's like in need of this and that. It was just a whole bunch. Like, honestly, the system is just, it's backwards. It's very backwards.
Well, I mean, it works better for you.
And nowadays,
you're just not using it as you should. You just don't know how to use it.
Yeah.
It works better for women. They could track this guy down. You have his social?
I don't have anything but a name and a license plate.
Oh, you got a license plate? That could be linked to an address if you look up a license plate online.
He might have the car in someone else's name.
I looked at the... I still have the address on file, but the license plate came up to. It was somewhere, like, in Lancaster, but, like I said, he has other properties and other people's names and stuff. And yeah, I even passed the house.
How would you prove that? You said that under someone else's name.
Because I Googled the name and I guess he's related to her in some way.
So, but how would you prove that it's his property?
That's another thing.
Because the burden of proof will be on you. It just says not mine.
Mm-hmm. Did he tell you he owned the property or?
Yeah, I've been to the property and everything. The only thing I can say is when he was doing his little tax thing, he had a customer, and then I was like, "Oh, who are you waiting on?" And they said him, and I was like, "Oh, so you know him?" I was like, "Yeah, I'll be buying cars from him and stuff." And I was like, "Oh, okay." So the only thing I really got is like one of his customers, and his business, I popped up at his business before, but it's all like, I feel like it's all ran by family, honestly.
He should have a dealer's license then. If he got a dealer's license, that should lead to an address.
Mm-hmm.
It seems like to me he's assuming no liability for any of these businesses. Completely dodging Uncle Sam.
His phone is not even in his name. I found that out.
They're on the top of the scammers list, the Nigerians.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. So that's why he's moving like that, huh? We have to send him back, huh? We're going to have to get him extradited. Expatriated. Send him back.
I wonder if he's done this to other women.
Citizenship. I feel like he has. I feel like he got so good at it. That's why he's not even worried about me or something. I don't know, but I really feel like he had. But I'm about to go eat. So how long is the podcast going to be? I might even have somebody join.
Yeah, you need to find that guy's information so we could try and help you track him down.
Oh, of course. Yeah, like I said, you encouraged me to do it now.
Was Lancaster address he's been lived in before?
Mm-hmm. I have to go through my notes to find the address again. And then I also got to go through all my pictures to see. Because I took a picture of everything. That's one thing I know how to do, record and take pictures.
Yeah, that's good. Record keeping is everything. This is interesting, though, because Lancaster is just a bunch of Amish people.
Lancaster, yeah. Ohio
is about
30 minutes away from Columbus.
Got you.
Yeah, it's close. Yeah, you thinking of Pennsylvania?
Yeah. Mm. Got you.
All right, sis. You need to track this guy down. Mm-hmm. This is one of the unique cases, man.
Yeah, you got to come back on, sis. You got to come back on, and maybe we can help you for sure.
I appreciate it. Thank you. I will. I enjoy talking to you guys and the subject. Now I'm about to eat my emotions away talking about this. Oof.
All right.
All right. Be safe. So have a good one. Be safe. Happy holidays.